Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's a long story and it's a long journey.
Oh, Jenny, I don't last yet also Paul.
A friend of mine introduced me to daddy.
Oh, Remy Con, Baba.
And as at that time, there is no hope again. There is no sign that we are going to come out from poverty. We are going to get our papers. How are we going to live? There is no hope. Everything was shut down. And she said to me, if you speak to Daddy Omolewa and hold on to every word he will tell you and keep your faith high, you will give a testimony.
Already, you are so for me, babe. See, your money, borrow, see, go, or no, see, or see, or see, or see, or see, or see, or see, Rui, but it's okay. Let's see, go, borrow, let you ready. Oh, Larry.
And I asked her, which church is this?
My wife, Billy, they pay you, Joe, what gun, Baba, you are.
He said, CAC.
Oh, one, Joe, Apostolic Christi.
And I started crying because I was baptized in CAC. My grandmother was attending CAC in Akure with Prophet Obadare. And I was 10 years then when I was baptized in Akure. We used to travel from Kwale in Delta State to Akure with my grandmother. So the next time I will hear of this CAC is through this lady, my friend. And I called daddy and he prayed. And he said, God will make you laugh. And in my heart, I said, this man don't know what we are passing through. That he is too big, and for him to just tell me, God will make you laugh. And he said, I should fetch water. And he prayed inside the water. We should use it to bath and sprinkle in the house. And the first time, there was a peace. When I mean there was a peace, we feel in our spirit that the hope have come. And I called my husband. I said, I am not troubled in my heart again. And my husband said to me, you know, you have been calling a lot of pastors concerning our situation. But God said to him, this is a man of God. So daddy said we should go back again and start our paper again.
Baba wa so fun mi wipe e pada lo gbe igbese lori awon iwe ti e n pe
se. But daddy, you are not in London.
Baba mo pe baba e ma si nilu oba e sun lu oyibo.
There are no is no. He said, my daughter, that says the Lord. Go back. I have to phone the lawyer again. The lawyer was even reluctant to pick my call. I said, we have to start because God said we should go back. And we start again. Even for the first 2 weeks, the letter came. Sorry, we receive your letter. We will look into your case. We never hear that from them. It's only no. That is what we hear. I don't want to keep everybody waiting. But the first thing I will say is that if daddy says something, connect your faith to it. Hold it very tight. And as you are going your daily business, continue to prophesy with that word. If I'm at work, I will say the God of Omolewa, you said we should go back. Come and show yourself. And I called daddy again to tell him how everything is going. He gives me another word again. He said, God said I will surprise you. I said, this man is coming again. I haven't even finished from I will make you laugh. Now he said, God said he will surprise me. We carry on again. The letters that we are coming, they were apologizing. And the daddy said another word again. He said, God have given your husband a ministry. And we make him one of my end time ministers. This word has so much now. And in my heart, in my spiritual heart, I put all those words in my back and tie it like a baby. And I'm going every day with it. And something starts to happen. From the time we start talking with daddy, we stop borrowing money from anybody to feed. I don't know how it happened. And I call him again. I say, if God could complete every word he give you, I said, I'm coming here with my children. And I want to stand in this altar. I said, I don't know how it will happen. But that is what the Spirit of God said to me. That if I believe, his son, he said, we are coming back to Lagos and stand in this altar and give testimony to his people. This time the paper hasn't come out. And I started saving for tickets. And I was in the office sitting there. I got a text message from the lawyer. He just said, good news. And I phoned him. I said, excuse me, sir. What do you mean by good news? He said, your paper is here. I said, no. I think you are talking to the wrong person. He said, I know your name. It's Esther, Apollos, and Kelechi.
Apollos.
I have your paper here. I brought it here. And this is it.
Only
this took us 22 years.
And
I went there to see by myself. And he gave me my own and my husband's own.
O fun mi ni ti emi ati ti oko mi.
And I was crying, I was calling daddy, I was crying, I was calling daddy.
Bi mo se npe baba ni mo sun ni mo sun kun ni mo npe won.
And I said, daddy, we are coming.
Mo ni baba a nbo.
I said, with this one that I have seen, I
said,
God is using you. We are coming to the church. And we bought tickets for everybody. For four of us to come. Because even my children, they have their own testimony. Every time daddy pray for them, he will say Pastor Joshua and Prophetess Ruth. And he said, put hand on them, let me pray for your two children. And I put hand on them and daddy pray with them on the phone. These children, one is 10 years and one is 12 years. After he prayed with them on the phone, there is nothing in the Bible these children don't know. My daughter, who is 10, we pray and preach. And they will give you a word of encouragement.
As if one year a month,
she will tell you what the Jesus said and what the Lord wants from you. And the benefit of serving God. She's just 10 years. My son. If you tell my son to preach here today, You won't believe how he's going to get the word. That was after daddy prayed for them. He said the Lord said that she should anoint them. And I was thinking on the phone. But it happens. I'm their mother. And I saw the changes. The next one again. Where I was working. In Nigeria, man is my manager. I was there before him. But when he came, he wants to take me out of that place. And I phone him again. Because I see him and I see God. He said, kneel down my daughter. Let me pray with you. And I kneel down in the same that office. He prayed. He uses his credits to call me and pray with me. If I say, let me call you back. He said, no, that says the Lord. I have to pray with you. It was 14 days. He prayed with me. That manager was transferred to today. I'm still working there. I am like a senior person in that place. I am the oldest person in that place. I was working there. I didn't have any paper. The police can come there and take you and bring you back home. But he said to me, my daughter, God said you will be there. And I was dirty today. The little word I have for everybody. Don't lose hope. As you enter here, let your hope and your faith be. If I can come to Nigeria here to give testimony, after the ticket we bought, the airline shut down. They didn't refund the money. I said to him, daddy, this is the problem. And there is a way he laughs when he's talking to me on the phone.
rin nigba to ba ba nba mi soro lori ero.
Just like how he was laughing here yesterday.
Bi won se nrerin lana.
Seriously, I will know something will happen. He didn't say a word when I told him we lost the ticket. But he was laughing. He was laughing. He was laughing. He said, my son, you are coming. That says the Lord. In 3 days, I got a check of 2,000 pounds.
£2,000
that the government is owing me.
See, ijoba nje mi.
I have never seen that before.
Emi o ri re eleyi ri.
They have never.
Wo ti iseru e ri.
I used to hear it.
Mo ma n gbo ni
that people receive that.
Ibi awon eyan kan ma n gbaru owo
be. But I got that check.
Sugbon mo gba iwe so we
lo. And there is something I want to say to you.
O nkan ti mo tun fe so fun ile eleyi.
No matter how small it is.
Ko ni fi se bo se kere to.
Please pay your tithe.
Ri daju wi pe o san ida mewa re.
Something happened.
Ohun kan sele.
I called him.
Mo pe won.
I called him every week.
Ah gbogbo ose
se ko ma pe won. Even midnight.
Loru ngba mi mo pe won.
He said to me.
Won wa so fun mi.
My daughter.
Obo mi obirin.
Are you paying your tithe?
Ijo ma san da mewa bi.
I said no daddy.
Mo wa pe daddy rara o.
He said that is it.
O ni ohun to sele niyan o.
And when I start.
Nigba ti mo wa bere.
Paying my tithe.
Ti mo bere si san ida mewa mi.
Everything. And it was one of those tithe and paying that makes me to stand here. If not, I couldn't have made it. I stayed 2 days in my village. We stayed 2 days in my husband's village. We came back here on Thursday. And me and my husband said, we have to use 1 week in this place. We have to spend 1 week with him. Because we know. When we go back, something will happen. When we go back, something will happen. It's about the ministry. He said to my husband, like what he was saying, he was running away. But daddy said you can't run again. You are in already. You are going to preach. We start the registration of the ministry. Every application we put, we did not receive any negative answer. In fact, when we go back, we are waiting for the certificate.
Areti iwe eri.
The place we are going to start the ministry.
Ibi ta ti bere ise iranse gan.
It's ready already.
O ti wa nle tele.
It's just to open the door.
Ka ko wa silekun ibe ni.
There are people who said I'm the choir.
Awon ko so pe emi ni akorin.
Another group of people they said I'm the usher.
Awon ko ti le wa nle to so pe awa la ma sasona.
People are calling to say, when are you coming back? We are waiting. All these things happen within 3 years. But we are there for 22 years. No matter how your situation is, the word is with him. Just come and receive the word. And put it into practice. And you will see the results. I didn't know you will favor me this way. I didn't know you will favor me this way.